Hey guys, it's Kevin. This is the second part of converting a ET8550 to a DTF printer. We're going to take the printhead out, convert it to nipples, and waterproof it. We're going to convert the dampers into V2 dampers. We need to take this cover off. See, this cover has two tabs, one on each side, and then there are two screw holes in the front. So we just unscrew the two screws in the front. In the step one, we already installed the clear tubes and the drag chain. We don't need this lock assembly at all, so we just totally remove it. We disconnect all the tubes. Now we can detach assembly from the dampers. We try to suck ink out of each damper. I'll put a link to all the products we used in the description. I'm going to put a direct link on the top right corner. There will still be a whole bunch of ink left in the damper. Now I'm going to remove it by park the printhead carriage on the capping station. By park, I mean you turn the printer on and wait until it rests on the capping station naturally. The outlet of the waste tube should be right here. However, I modified this printer. I took the waste tube out. Here is the outlet. So now I attach to the waste tube. I'm going to draw slowly. This is speed up. I don't draw this fast. You're going to draw slowly until the ink is empty. Now we're ready to take dampers out. We flip the metal tab towards you. We can lift up the damper vertically. You're going to do the middle one first. Use the syringe to clean it up. Use a paper towel to dab everything dry. Before unscrew the printhead, there are four screws to remove and the print can be lifted straight up. You can see, although we're being really careful, we still have a fair amount of ink coming down on the bottom. Look at the ink here. Oh, by the way, since we're already here, not only we're going to convert, and also we're going to show you how to seal the printhead. On the BCH website, we have a small silicone seal for those. However, we're going to use a larger tube this time. Whenever you're going to seal electronics, it's a good idea to test your sealant first. Make sure your sealant is non-conductive when it's wet, so it will be safe to work around the printheads without waiting them to set. You can install them wet. Then we need a size 1 or size 0 Phillips screwdriver. We take off those screws on the bottom. You want to save and guard those screws like your life depends on it, because if you lost them, you'll never get a replacement. Then put your hand and separate the PCB board from the body. You might have ink stuck on it, and so you just use a razor blade. Just poke a little bit, it should be severed really easily. You shouldn't require any kind of brute force. So if you find it really hard, probably you bought a refurbished printhead, which Epson super glued the core to the cover. So there's no way you can convert it to a nipple. One telltale sign is your screw will be black instead of silver. I have a video for that. You can click above and check it out. Oh, this tip is going to save your life. See the base and this tab? Where on the other side have a serial number? That goes the side with two holes on the top. So you don't want to install this upside down. Now it's new over new base. We put it aside with a serial tab on the top. We put it aside with two holes on the top and put it in. Now we put the four screws in. You want to tighten the two diagonal screws first, then you go around, tighten each one, and now we're ready to waterproof it. There are other things you can do. For example, you can put a printed cover, and we also have a printed sleeves. But for this, we simply apply the silicone seal. This edge is most likely the ink going to get in. Here's where the cleanup pad is used for. If you ever got a tile or seal your toilet before, you got an idea. The last thing you want to seal is the FFC cable, but you have to insert the cable first, then seal it. Oh, don't do this. I'm just showing you. You have a nipple now, so you can do those stuff. We install the printhead back to the printer. And now we insert the V2 damper. Now on each damper, we're going to insert an adapter. Here's the ink intake, and here's the end of a barb. Okay, see, there's a distance between the base and the end of the barb. Your kit will come with a piece of C3 tube. Put this tube a little above the barb. I'll say about a half of the distance from the barb to the base. Then we cut it a little bit above the barb. So basically the tube look like divided by half, half in the barb, half not. It form like a cone. And now we can insert the adapter. What you want is have no gap between the adapter and the...
Perfect.
Now take the small sleeve, insert it in the small hole like this. Put the adapter on all the dampers. Four of the dampers will connect to the clear tube directly. The clear tube is a C2 connection. For C2, we're going to use the elbows. So just insert the larger end of the elbow into the damper. The smaller side is going to connect to the clear tube. Then there are two tubes we'll use for white ink. The white ink tube is a C3 connection. Basically, C3 connection is just two straight tubes. In the next video, we're going to show you how to insert this really good looking assembly and connect all the tubes on your printhead. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!